Alright YouTube, I will show you how to unlock peak graphics on Warzone Mobile, but before we start, you need to log out of your main account and create a secondary account for this fun exercise, because the app frame gen will trigger the game's anti-cheat software, causing you to get banned. So use it at your own risk. I am not responsible for any damage to your account or your device. Also, you will need root for this procedure, either Magisk version 27 Canary with Shamiko or A-Patch Kernesu with Zygisk next. Unfortunately, this method only seems to work on Snapdragon Adreno GPU 640 and up, which are Snapdragon 855 or newer, Snapdragon 778 or newer, and lastly, at this current time, Snapdragon 6th Gen 1. YouTube, as you can see here, I'm on version 26.4 on Magisk. We need to be on 27 in order for this to work. Let's open our web browser and type Magisk in the search bar. It should be the first link on top of the page. Select it. Scroll down to find the list of the builds and select Magisk Canary in orange. Scroll down and select app release.apk to download it. You need another module called Shamiko in order for it to work. Scroll down and download the latest Shamiko module for Magisk. Alright, once everything downloaded, open your file manager and use it Z Archiver. Go to your downloads folder and install the latest Magisk APK. As you can see, we now have the latest Magisk app installed, version 27. Go to settings in Magisk, switch update channel to Canary. Go back and install the latest Magisk 27006 direct install. Reboot, reopen Magisk. As you can see, the latest version finally installed. Go to settings, ensure Zygisk enabled. We can now install Shamiko module. So go to downloads folder and install the latest Shamiko module. Restart your device again. Reopen Magisk. As you can see, finally installed successfully. Remember, we now need to hide Magisk app from Call of Duty Warzone or else it will crash. So rename the Magisk app to the one in this video or something else you're more comfortable with. Okay, go to settings again, scroll down, configure deny list, select Call of Duty Warzone, go back. As you can see, the name successfully changed, so from Magisk to Sue. Now it's time to download frame generation on your phone. Open your web browser and type LYBX LPSV in the search bar. It should be the first link on your web page. Once you're on the page, click on home page on frame generation for Android. A friendly reminder to please read everything on this page. As you can see here in the technical caveats, there is no guarantees that this will not cause game anti-cheat bans. That is really important. So use at your own risk. I recommend to create a secondary account just in case. Do not use a personal account. As you scroll down, select download FG app and module. Download module and application. Once downloaded, open your file manager again, go to downloads folder, install the FameGen app first, install. As you can see, I already have it installed. Once installation completed, open Magisk, go to modules and install the FameGen module. Okay, reboot device. All right, YouTube, before I do any configuration, let me just show you the little settings first. Graphics, very low. There's no peak option. And resolution is also low. All right, let's just see low graphics. Now let's close this game. Let's go straight to configuration now. Open FameGen. Front. That's normal. Reopen it. Make sure you read everything. Very important. Agree. Open it again. Go to settings, enable experimental configurables, go to global setting, leave it as default, go to app select, let's search for Warzone mobile, COD Warzone, which is this one, click on the gear icon, enable FameGen, game library is Vulkan, method, use A640, which is Snapdragon 855 and up. If you have Snapdragon 700 series, this should work with 778 and up. Not sure about Snapdragon 600 series. Presets, let's select none at the moment. I don't want to use FameGen. Let's see the actual FPS with Snapdragon A65, Adreno 650. Overlay, show FPS, that's okay, disabled. FPS threshold disabled for now. Cult mode, let's select very low for now. FameGen mode, let's select no processing. Reset, let's leave that default. Ultimate, let's leave that default. Scroll down, leave that default setting. Enable, ignore presentation time. Enable spoof into A750. Now with that we can get Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 features such as the peak option. Spoof into A750 is tick. Let's quickly check our settings. Leave these as default, no processing. Make sure hardware A640 enabled. Save. That's it. Let's go back. Back again. App select. Okay, that should be everything. Okay. Now let's open Warzone Mobile again. It seems that it detect some changes. Give it a few minutes. This is normal. Okay, let's quickly check the settings now, our graphic settings. And just like that, peak option is now available to select. Peak, resolution low, let's keep like that, shadow quality low.
weapons free.
I've seen some nice reflections already. Nice reflections.
The lead is ours.
Look at the difference in texture quality. Very nice indeed. Some nice foliage.
The enemy's taking the lead.
Look at the truck textures. I'm not sure, but I think the resolution on Snapdragon 865 is lower than Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 on the same low resolution preset. Can someone with the Galaxy S20 and the Galaxy S24 go to developer options and enable GPU watch and tell me what resolution I've seen for very low and peak for visual quality on the same low resolution preset? Screenshot the result and send it to one of my socials. On Twitter, Instagram or TikTok. Thank you.
Changing max.
Wow. Nice change of quality indeed. Okay, let's try a different map.
Kill confirmed. Eliminate targets and secure their tags to win.
Okay, let's double check our settings. Still have key graphics. The resolution. Some nice reflections here.
The enemy's gaining ground. Push them back.
Grenade out! I know my FPS in 35, 50 FPS, but it's not 50 FPS, it doesn't feel 50 FPS. So yeah, thanks for watching, please like and subscribe.